Welcome back to AgriTalk at the Farm Progress Show site in Decatur, Illinois. Barry Soloday is with us. He's field agronomist for Syngenta. I want to talk about crop conditions here in central Illinois. When folks come to the Farm Progress Show site, what will they see? And last time we were here, we were looking at crops that were well behind and needing some good warm weather to catch up. Well, we're getting that, and they have made a lot of certainly advances since then, but there are still some challenges now. We want to talk about that. Barry, thanks for being with us. It is amazing how this corn has shot up here the last few weeks.
Yeah, it really has. It's I think it's amazing how far we've come. If you think we almost planted about a month behind normal, and our pollination is really about 10 days behind normal. So we've already caught up a lot on the heat units. And when I look at the corn crop right now, I'm just really surprised how good it looks. We kind of got off to a little bit of a slow start, a little bit of a rough start, but things have gotten pretty uniform and they look pretty good. I'm really pleased with where we're at on the corn crop, and soybeans have come a long way as well. I think the beans look real good. The only thing I'm kind of watching right now on the beans is we're in that full bloom time frame, and I think the beans look good, but I'm a little worried about some of these later planted beans that are in 30-inch rows, closing those rows, maybe some late season weed escapes and things like that.
Seems like a lot of short beans, which doesn't necessarily mean they won't yield well, but it really stands out as you're looking at them from what we're used to in this part of the country this time of year.
Yeah, I'd agree. The beans just didn't have that early season growth that a lot of times we're able to get on them. That really won't necessarily have any impact on yield, but it will have some impact on like we talked about, being able to close those rows in a timely fashion and help shade out any weed pressure late season.
What do we see? We know there are a lot of holes in some of these fields from the wet conditions early this year. There was some nitrogen loss in places and some things like that. So different things that farmers are dealing with. And as you mentioned, the timing is just off a little bit, set back a little bit. So what are some things to keep in mind that maybe we wouldn't be thinking about at this particular stage of the growing season?
Right. I think right now is a pretty critical time to start thinking about a fungicide application on your corn. If you get to that R1 time frame, which is silking, that's the time to start thinking about getting your Quilt Excel on. I'm a big fan of the R1 time frame. And then at that same time is a good opportunity to check for any silk clippers, Japanese beetles, corn rootworm beetles, things like that. You could have an opportunity to throw in some Warrior and really clean up that field and set it off nicely.
I've been hearing about Japanese beetles. Are they a problem, a big problem this year?
Well, thus far they haven't. They came in kind of heavy initially, but they haven't blown up bigger yet. So I think it's something we really want to keep an eye on. If you watch, when you scout your fields or even around your home, you'll notice they really tend to congregate. So on home they'll congregate on ornamentals. In the fields, you'll see them in pockets in the field, throughout the field, kind of in pockets.
You mentioned scouting your fields. That's very important, isn't it?
I think it's super important to scout your fields. There's no way to know what you're going to have in harvest if you don't take a little time to get out there right now and see what you've got. We talked about putting on that fungicide, maybe fungicide and insecticide on your corn. It's the same way on soybeans. On beans, I think personally I like to see you go out there at that R3 time frame, which is at pods, when pods first start to set in one of the top four nodes, and they're about 3/16 of an inch long. That's the time, and you want to go out there with a product like Quadris. And personally, I always like to see guys go ahead and put an insecticide on your soybeans. Seems like that is one of those situations where one and one equals more than two.
So after a slow start, we have the potential for a pretty good crop.
I think definitely so, especially on the corn. I'm just really pleased with the way it has greened up and evened up. As I walked fields this last week, I was really happy with where things were. And on soybeans, I mean, we're just a little earlier yet because they got planted just a little bit later. But we're on our way. I think we have opportunities here. The market's here. I think we need to do everything we can to ensure as much yield as possible for this crop.
Still a ways to go, but it looks like we have a chance. And we're beginning to wonder about that, the way this spring was going in some places. But certainly for most of central Illinois, things have improved greatly. All right, Barry, thanks a lot. Good to see you.
Thanks for having me.
Very good. Barry Soloday, he is a field agronomist with Syngenta. Again, our Farm Progress Show preview series brought to you by Syngenta. Coming up next, Matt Youngman, National Events Manager for Farm Progress, will give us an update on show preparations, as we can now say next month will be the Farm Progress Show, and also, again, give us a look at some of the new and different things that will be available and will be going on here at the show site. So stay with us. Much more to come from Decatur, Illinois. It's halftime on AgriTalk.